Hi, I'm Justin Cross with AvoidForeclosureCharlotte.com, and I'm thrilled that you're watching this video, which means that you took the time to enter your name and email address, and we're on our way to short sale success. And we're gonna start with talking about the sign-up process, which is really a bunch of paperwork, and it falls into a couple of categories of paperwork. The first component is the actual sign-up process with your realtor. So you're going to sign a listing agreement and usually a short sale addendum and a few more paperwork related documents that allow your realtor to be able to represent you during this transaction. They'll be able to go over this with you in person, or you can just do it via email if you're comfortable signing the documents. And it's also something that protects you, because after all, you are signing your name on something that essentially says, okay, I'm gonna be willing to sell this property at a certain price, but of course, with a short sale, you need lien holder approval. So this is all spelled out in the contract for you. So then you have your realtor documents that allow you to actually list the property. But then there's another component that is the actual short sale document letter of authorization. This letter of authorization is something that you can physically fill out, and it'll allow your realtor or the attorney or whatever third-party vendors are helping you with your short sale, they'll be able to communicate with your bank. This is where the homeowner grant access to those vendors in order to help you be able to communicate directly with the bank. As a side point, this can also be done orally. Sometimes the banks actually demand you, the homeowner, to call in for that letter of authorization. And then the third component would be the financial documents. So the bank is going to want to see, for example, bank statements regularly throughout the process. They're going to want to see tax returns. They're going to want to see a hardship letter, and this hardship letter actually spells out how you got where you are and why you were in a situation in which you need to have debt settled or you need to have your home sold via the short sale process. So those three steps in review, again, are the actual realtor documents that you need to engage your realtor. So those are the listing documents. Then you have the letter of authorization that allows your third-party vendors to contact the bank and initiate the short sale. And then you have your financial documents, which is what the bank wants to see, that shows the status of your financial situation and allows them to do the short sale. So this is our first installment of short sale success. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.